They're taking a picture there. We have our own stand-up comedian in our park, Frank. Frank Pomilio is our comedian for the day, so come to the stage, Frank.
Either way. All right, I was on a camping trip. We were on a bus, and we went, the driver let us out, and we were going through the woods and down trails. And then all of a sudden, the driver starts saying, come back, get back on the bus, get back on the bus. I said, why? I said, there's a bear coming. So we heard that we got back on the bus except old Millie, and she was pretty slow. So she's coming, the bear's getting closer and closer. She's almost on the bus, and the bear's getting close. And she's just at the bus door, and the driver slammed the door in her face. She said, what are you doing? He says, company rules. No one's on the line on the bus with the bear behind. Went to the apartment building, and I figured, well, I'm the age I am, and there's a lot of gals here, about my same age, some a little bit younger. So I put a sign on the door. It said, sex. On the couch, $20. On a chair, $10. On the floor, $5. So pretty soon I hear a real timid knock on the door, and I look, and there's a little old lady with a $20 bill in her hand. I said, oh, you put one on the couch. She says, no, I'm on four on the floor. Where in this nursing home, this one gal had a big skirt on, and she kept running through the building, flipping her skirt around and saying, super sex, super sex, super sex. This one guy says, I'll take the soup. It was a beautiful, sunshiny Saturday morning, and Mrs. Skunk wanted to clean out her tree trunk den. But she had two twins, two little boys named In and Out, little baby skunks. So she said, In and Out, go out and play, get out of here, so I can clean up. So after a while, Out comes in. She says, Out, why are you in? And where's In? Out says, Out, In's out. She says, well, go get him. So Out went out to get In to bring In In. So he came in, and she said, Out, how did you find In so quickly? He said, easy, instinct. This one guy thought that his wife was cheating on him, so he hired this Chinese detective. And the Chinese detective was supposed to follow and record everything on the note. So they met the Chinese detective. He said, well, how'd it go? He says, He said, what happened? Well, BCD, BC she. They go in the building, we know can't see. They go upstairs. So we climb three. Now we can see. He played with she played with he, we played with me, we follow the tree, he knows sees. There was a silly young fellow named Clyde in a funeral carriage. He was five. When asked who is dead, he giggled and said, I don't know, I just came along for the ride. There was a train that was heading south from the New England states. Was heading to Norfolk. And Virginia and Jerry, the wife and husband, were on their honeymoon. And Jerry was trying to get Ginny in the bedroom if he could, if they were on the train. So they're on the train, sitting in their seats, and he decides to eat a sandwich. The conductor comes and says, Boston, Massachusetts, no eating in the train. You gotta go in the eating room. So we went in the eating room. And he pulls out a bottle of wine. He started drinking wine. He said, no drinking wine, you gotta go to the drinking car. They went to the drinking car. And then he starts nuzzling up the car again. He says, no, no, none of that stuff. You gotta go in the room. So they went in their room. And Gary took Ginny in the room, and Ginny, oh, at last, I got Ginny all by myself. I'm not really going to love you. And the doctor came by and said, no, fall to Virginia. Next time I'm going to drive myself. Then there was one time when this old lady wanted to have a chance at winning a contest. And so she was focusing on getting her picture taken. So she had the camera and him, and she was there with her daughter. The daughter says, what's he doing now? She says, well, he's taking his equipment out. Okay. Now what's he doing? Oh, he's setting it up. Now what's he doing? Now he's going to focus. She says, focus? Oh, well. Well, I think that might do it, except I wanted to tell you we were all pretty thirsty earlier, but I didn't tell you, did I? We had no water. And I said, well, the system's all shut down, you got to get water somewhere. The guy told me, well, there's a dam down under the hill. So I went to the dam. And here there's a guy that he's in charge of it. He would give me any. So I told everybody when I came back that I went to the dam and get some damn water. I asked the damn man if I could have some damn water. The damn man said I couldn't have any damn water. So I told the damn man to keep the damn water in the damn water.